everyone. Today we're going to do coasters with very nice cells on them. They're sort of reversible, but the reverse side is much better than the front side, but you can use anything. I use Faux Rizzle resin. You can use anything. Just make sure it's not very liquid. Like the casting resin probably will not work. You can try, but I think it will move too fast. The pigments that I use Arteza pigments. They're a little metallic. They look very, very good. I will put in the names. It's one of the dark ones, mostly charcoal. One is a little pinkish gold in a way. For the white, I use the one that I use for the waves. It's Breaking White. It's on Etsy from an artist that is a master of the waves. It looks really well. But you can use pretty much anything. And the Rebel Glitter from Just For You Online UK. The Rebel Glitter is amazing. So we separate into the four different cups. Three for the pigments, one is completely clear with nothing on them. And we start mixing in our pigments. So we're going to start with the one that is pinkish gold, and I put in about, I think, 1/4 teaspoon of those pigments. You can put more. I mean, you just remember the rule of the 10% of the whole volume, no more can be the glitter, otherwise it's not going to be mixed, it's not going to cure as it should. So put in the pigments and mixed them really well. I mixed in black, added the glitter, mixed it up as well. You have to be sure that it's not very transparent. I think that's when the pigments are very transparent. They're not going to look very good because there's not going to be that distinction between the colors, between, you know, and the cells. So I saw the black, it didn't look as dark as I wanted it to. So I added something from Counterculture DIY. They have something called Black Diamond. It's an intense color. And pretty much all that you need of those colors is a drop. More than that, and it becomes too heavy, it doesn't cure very well, so one drop is enough of any of their intense colors. So just drop it in, mix it really well, you're good to go. For the white, I started out putting maybe 5 to 6 drops. As you can see, I mean, I tried to count, but it kind of squirted out, but about 6 drops. That is, I mixed it. It was white, but it looked, when I put the thing out, it looked a little transparent, so I added a little bit more. Basically, it has to be heavy, and it has to be very, very white. For the clear one, once you put it, I mean, you know, we mix it very well for 3 minutes in the main mixing cup. Yes, 3 minutes it takes to mix very well, scrubbing from the sides and everything to make sure that nothing unmixed and still something may be. So we put it in a separate cup, we make sure we mix it again, you know, from on the sides, on the bottom, scrape it from the sides to make sure that it's all good. And we can start putting everything in. So we start with the black color or with whichever darker color you choose. Once again, you don't have to pick my colors. You can pick your own. It has to be something dark, something a little bit lighter. White is very important. You cannot do anything without it. At least not this particular coaster. And then the clear one. And you can see how the white and the clear works in order for it to become the cells that we wanted to become. And you might see that, you may hear that what I'm doing and what I'm talking about is not really coinciding, and that's because I tried talking in the mask, and yes, I use the mask. You have to use the mask for protection. I tried talking into it and didn't work out very well. Nobody could hear me, so I'm recording this after the fact. So we put on the black first. After that, the pinkish gold goes in. So we put the black near, around the edges, make sure all the edges are filled, especially when it's something like this, where it's a gas slice, so it has all those dips and valleys. Make sure all those dips and valleys have resin in them. Because, I mean, you don't have to, but it's just not going to look good. I mean, there's a reason why this mold is that way, has to look this way. So after we put in the second color in, don't mix them together. They're going to be mixed later. Make sure that, you know, one color is on the outside, another color is on the inside. And after that, we take the white and we put it in the middle. We cover all of the middle in white. And once again, don't mix them. You can see they're not really mixing together anyway. I mean, there's some movement and you have to make sure that there's movement. But resin moves on its own. So with the white, you can see slight movement that it kind of like white moves towards the other colors. But not really. What's going to move it is this. It's the clear color. You put it right in the middle and you fill it up. So you see that it moves everything out and it's going to move them to the edges. And it's going to fill up the your mold. So you just put in as much clear as to make everything, you know, to fill up the mold. And you can see how it moved everything. You don't, can't even see the golden one, the gold pink one. And then all you have to do is just make sure you put a little torch, kill the bubbles. And I tried with a heat gun. It kind of moves it a bit, so probably not. With a torch, just be careful about your mold. And then we just wait for it. Wait for it. And here we go. Now we can unmold. And I molded it before I pressed record, so I kind of put it back together and make sure that I sort of like I'm unmolding it again. I'm sorry. I didn't know. I didn't push record. But this is how they come out. And you can see the dark on the sides with the glitter. And the glitter, somebody told me, looks like shells, like tiny shells. And it's really awesome. It does. I didn't even think about it. But yeah, it does sort of look like little shell pieces. But the gold is kind of underneath the white. And this those beautiful cells that appear. So it's like within the frame of the dark and shell, there's this sort of ghostly, I don't know, I want to say eye, but it's kind of strange, doesn't it? But it's like a cell, maybe, like a huge cell, like something. And this is a lighter. I tried to put lighter. We have 30 days of rain in Seattle. It's very dark. But it looks really awesome. So try doing it and tag me on Instagram if you do it. And thank you for watching.